Hello everyone, my name is Joel Moriana and in this presentation I am going to talk about co-simulation in CARLA. Specifically, we are going to see how to integrate or connect CARLA with external traffic simulators. We split the presentation into 5 different blocks. We will start with a brief introduction of the co-simulation concept. Then we will have 2 blocks explaining how to run CARLA with 2 different external traffic simulators, Sumo and PTV VSim. Then we will do a quick overview regarding the internal design, and we will finish talking about the limitations and some of the future work. So, as I have said at the beginning of the presentation, co-simulation is about connecting CARLA to external traffic simulators. So everything that is happening in the traffic simulator is happening as well in CARLA and vice versa. So this is providing us the possibility to use third-party software to simulate traffic in CARLA instead of using the traffic manager module that CARLA is currently providing. Specifically, we are going to talk about Sumo and PTV VSim. The objective of both traffic simulators are quite similar. They are focused on microscopic traffic simulations, and you can achieve very similar behaviors with both of them. So let's start with the Sumo co-simulation. The easiest way to run a co-simulation between CARLA and Sumo is by executing the spawn MPC Sumo script. This script imitates the behavior of the spawn MPC script that we are already providing, but the vehicles, instead of being managed by the traffic manager, are managed by Sumo. The way it works is very simple. You just have to execute the script and it automatically detects the CARLA map that is active and generates all the necessary files in order to run a Sumo simulation. Similarly to the spawn MPC script, you can customize the behavior of the simulation through several parameters. So, for instance, you can choose the number of vehicles that you want to spawn, set a pattern to filter the vehicle types, enable or disable the synchronization of vehicle lights and vehicle colors, or choose which simulator, CARLA or Sumo, is in charge of the management of the traffic lights. We call this type of co-simulation random because the Sumo vehicle types are spawned randomly and the routes of each one of the vehicles are also updated randomly. So this can generate highly unrealistic routes and behaviors, so depending on the type of study that the user is performing, maybe this is not the proper way to run a co-simulation between Sumo and CARLA. So the other way to run a co-simulation between CARLA and Sumo, that we call custom co-simulation, is by executing the run synchronization script. The main difference between this script and the previous one is that in this case the user has to indicate the Sumo simulation that is going to be executed in CARLA. So the user can create his own simulation in Sumo and run it with CARLA. The parameters that the user can select are very similar to the ones of the spawn MPC Sumo script. So, for instance, we can enable or disable the synchronization of vehicle lights and vehicle colors and choose who is in charge of the traffic lights. But it should be noted that here we cannot set the number of vehicles that are going to be spawned or the vehicle types through the parameters, because all this information is inside the definition of the Sumo co-simulation. So now we are going to see what contains this file and how we can create it in order to run it with CARLA. So this file, the Sumo CFG file, is a file gathering all the configuration of the simulation, and it is mainly composed of 2 different files. The SumoNet or Sumo Network, which is a file defining the static environment. It is like an open drive, but in another format. And then we have the traffic demand, which can be defined through root files. and contains the definition of the vehicle types and the routes for each one of the vehicles that are going to be spawned during the simulation. And here we can see a basic configuration file, which contains references to the Sumo network and the Sumo routes. And now we're going to see how to create those files, the Sumo network and the traffic demand. And we're going to do this through an example in which we're going to show all the necessary steps in order to run a custom co-simulation between Carla and Sumo. So the first step is the generation of the Sumo network. The recommended way to do this is with the NetConvert Carla script. You just have to execute this script indicating the OpenDrive file you want to convert to Sumo format and where do you want to save it. Internally, this script is using the NetConvert tool provided by Sumo. Here you can see all the parameters that we are using to call it. But instead of letting NetConvert to add the traffic lights into the resulting Sumo network, we are adding them manually. This has been done to improve the integration of the Carla traffic lights in the Sumo world. The second step is the generation of a library of Sumo vehicle types based on the Carla blueprints. This step is not mandatory, but it allows having straightforward conversions from Carla blueprints to Sumo vehicle types and vice versa. So basically, this script relies on a JSON file in which the user can add custom Sumo attributes for each one of the Carla blueprints. And the output of this file is a Sumo root file containing the definition of each Carla blueprint. The dimension attributes, that is the length, width, and height, are automatically retrieved from the Carla blueprint, even if they are not set in the JSON file. Then it's time to generate the traffic demand. There are several ways to generate traffic demands, but the simplest one is by using the NetEdit tool provided by Sumo. When following this approach, we need first to load the generated Sumo network and the Sumo vehicle types in NetEdit, and then we can just manually generate routes, as we can see in the GIF of the slide. So routing Sumo is just the definition of all the edges through which the vehicle is going to pass. And then we can simply select the vehicles that are going to be spawned on each route. As previously, we have loaded the Sumo vehicle types library. We can now select directly Carla blueprints inside Sumo. In the example, we are selecting the Carla Cola blueprint. So once we have this, we simply export the simulation and run it with the run synchronization script and the desired parameters. So that's all regarding the Sumo co-simulation. Now we're going to talk about PTBBSim co-simulation. So unlike Sumo, in PTBBSim, we only have one way to execute co-simulation, that is through the run synchronization script. So in the same way as with Sumo, we need to indicate the PTBBSim simulation file that we want to execute in Carla. In this case, is this impx file. Here we also have parameters to customize the behavior of the simulation, but they are quite more limited. The most important one is the simulator vehicles parameter, and this parameter sets the number of Carla vehicles that are going to be passed to BSim. This is a limitation that we have due to PTBBSim, and by default this parameter has a value of 1, so only one Carla vehicle is going to be passed to PTBBSim. So if you want to synchronize more vehicles, you will have to initialize the co-simulation with the proper number here. Okay, so let's follow the same procedure than with Sumo, and let's explain what is this INPX file and how we can create it. So unlike Sumo, PTBBSim defines all the logic of the simulation in only one file, the INPX file, that is defining the entire BSim traffic network with all the elements and that belong to it. So let's see how to create it through an example. It's quite simple. You just have to import the OpenDrive file into PTBBSim and then create your demanding models using all the tools provided by PTBBSim. And then, and this is a very important step, we have to activate the driving simulator interface and specify the simulator and vehicle, the simulator vehicle and pedestrian types. One important thing to take into account here is that any vehicle spawned in Carla will be spawned in PTBBSim using those types. I will talk more about this in this in the next slide. So basically, we have that the synchronization of vehicle types between PTBBSim and Carla is not straightforward. We differentiate between two situations. On the one hand, we have the synchronization from a Carla blueprint to a PTBBSim vehicle type. As we have said in the previous slide, this is not configurable, and any vehicle spawned in Carla will have the BSim type selected during the activation of the driving simulator interface. On the other hand, we have the synchronization from a PTBBSim vehicle type to a Carla blueprint, and the user can customize this synchronization through a JSON file, and here in the slide we have an example of how this file is structured. So for instance, this, the vehicle BSim, the BSim vehicle type 200 will be spawned as a Carla cola in Carla, and the BSim vehicle type 100 will be spawned as one of the Carla blueprints provided in this list. So once we have this, we simply export the simulation and run it with the run synchronization script and the desired parameters. So quite similar to how Sumo works. So let's talk now about the internal design of the co-simulation. So the architecture of the co-simulation is mainly composed of two clients connecting to each one of the servers. On the one hand, we have the Carla client, which is using the Python API to communicate with the Carla world. And on the other hand, we have the traffic simulator client to communicate with the traffic simulator. For Sumo, we are using Tracy and the Tracy API to communicate with the Sumo server. And for PTBBSim, we are using the driving simulator interface. The driving simulator interface is an add-on module that is not incorporated in the vanilla license of PTBBSim, so it has to be acquired. Both servers are set to run in synchronous mode and with the same frame rate. And then on every tick, we update all the information from one simulator to the other one. So to do this, we rely on the Bridge Helper component, which is a component to translate the information from one world to the other one. Specifically, right now, the Bridge Helper is translating data regarding blueprints, that is, from a Carla blueprint to the proper vehicle type of the traffic simulator and vice versa. Regarding transforms, that is location and rotation, and regarding vehicle lights and traffic lights. Okay, let's talk now about the limitations. Regarding general limitations that are affecting to both integrations, to Sumo and PTBBSim, we have that the traffic simulator vehicles are teleported in Carla, and therefore the physics of the vehicles are disabled. This may produce issues when a Carla vehicle collides with a vehicle managed by the traffic simulator. Then we have limitations affecting only to to one traffic simulator. For instance, regarding the sumo simulation limitations, we have that the traffic lights of the current Karla towns are not integrated with sumo because they are not defined in the OpenDrive file, and therefore the NetConvert tool cannot generate them. And regarding PTVB simco simulation limitations that are mainly introduced by the driving simulator interface, and we have already talked about them during the presentation, we have that the Karla vehicles passed to PTVB sim only can have one vSim vehicle type, the one indicated during the activation of the driving simulator interface. And then we have also that the number of vehicles passed to PTVB sim need to be stated before starting the co-simulation through the simulator vehicles parameter. Lastly, regarding future work, we have the integration of pedestrian co-simulation between the traffic simulators and Karla. Also, the improvement of the integration of some Karla towns with sumo. The NetConvert tool is not working perfectly with some complex OpenDrive files and sometimes generates wrong junction shapes. And lastly, we have the synchronization of traffic lights in PTVB sim. That is something that also can be done in the future. So that's all regarding co-simulation. Thank you very much for your attention, and don't hesitate to contact us through the Karla forum or Discord in case of any doubt or question.